my personal view, and the view actually of the Gita, very much in essence, is that our lives are meant for helping others, very much. Materially, emotionally, and spiritually. In Krishna consciousness, obviously, we very much focus on the spiritual aspect. But that doesn't mean we should neglect the other two, the emotional and the material. Health, obviously, is something which is of utmost importance to any spiritualist. But if we can help someone to live a little further, why not?
So if their organs are removed from there for the betterment of other human beings, and then this is something which is considered as a very high donation. And personally, I believe in, and I have been an organ card donor for many, many years, and I have not restricted. I said, you can take any part of my body.
We believe that there is nothing within our dharma which says we mustn't give organs. In fact, it's positively encouraging. And so as a Hindu body, we are encouraging our members to sign up. And the way to start is to sign up ourselves. And I am already a card-carrying member.
In Hinduism, there is no bar. On the contrary, Hindus and the scriptures encourage donations. Organ donation is the supreme donation among four or five donations.
From whatever the scriptures I have so far read, I can make out that there is no impediment as such for Hindus to make an organ donation and to put their organs into use after the death.
To the best of my knowledge, there is nothing in the Hindu scriptures that prohibits the practice of organ donation. In fact, we know that our scriptures, our spiritual leaders, they encourage what we call dan or donation. They encourage seva, serving others. Our spiritual leader, His Holiness Pramukh Swami Maharaj, often says, in the joy of others lies our own.
Swami Prabhupada, very much in keeping with the tradition of the Gita, which states that this body is not really the real self. The real self is the spirit, the atma, the soul. And that's very important. The body is not really that important. It will be gone at the end of this life.
So this is one form of dana as well, in which we can help other people after the soul has left the body. Because even though the soul is eternal, the body is perishable. And once the body has gone, then if that body or the organs in that body can help somebody else to live, that in itself is a great act of punya or merit.
Well, if you give money to an organization or give our time to a volunteer organization, that's good. But giving our organ, a part of our body, is even greater. You imagine it makes a difference in somebody else's life. But the recipient of the organ, think about the children, the family, the in-laws, the brothers and sisters, who see their relation as somebody who's now active and recovered. So it's the greatest deed you can do in your whole life.
If you believe in organ donation,
prove it.
Call 0300 123 23 23,
or text register
to 84880, or log on to www.organdonation.nhs.com. Oh, UK.